Hi, I'm Ibrahim Muluk here from YouTube API Developer Relations team. If you're an iOS developer and you are trying to find the best way to start integrating YouTube APIs into your app, we have a great news for you guys. We open sourced YouTube Direct Lite for iOS recently, and this project demonstrates the best practices for using the YouTube APIs inside your app, such as using the YouTube Data API, YouTube Data API uploads, as well as the iframe embedded player. And YouTube Direct Lite is actually a platform itself so that people can solicit for videos from their users, so that their users can submit videos to their playlist so that they can moderate and choose which videos to show up in that playlist. And for that, inside the app, your users can actually use this app so that they can record any video, or they can pick any video that they recorded earlier and upload to YouTube and submit to your playlist, as well as they can pick any video they already uploaded to YouTube before and then still submit to your playlist. And let's go to my screen and actually see here from here. So the project is hosted under GitHub. It's under github.com/YouTube Direct Lite iOS. And in this project, we are using the Objective-C client libraries for Google APIs so that it handles the auto authorization and it makes it really easy to talk with the good YouTube Data API. Let's go to project itself and see the project from there. Here actually starts with the authorization, the auto, and we are given the authorization. And we are logging into my account, and we are actually authorizing this app to use my account. Now actually the app is going through, and it's actually going through my playlist, my upload playlist, and pulling all the playlist items from there. And through the videos list call, it actually goes like for all these videos, it brings up the video's titles, the view count, as well as the video duration. And we are also bringing the YouTube thumbnails as well. So if we click any of the videos here, we are actually inserting the YouTube iframe embed player. And here actually it's using the Apple's own streamer. If you are like wanna go for the full screen, that's one option. Or from the iframe embed playing options, you can actually set plays in line one so that actually the player actually will play the video inside the application. So after seeing like any video, we can submit it to a playlist. Or we can actually record a complete new video with the camera, or we can actually pull one of the videos I have in my already saved in my iOS device. And from there, I can actually even play the video before selecting. And if I'm sure I want to upload this video, videos playing, I can set like a new title. And I can start the video. Right now we are using the YouTube Data API resume uploads. So the upload is like going on the background as well. And once the upload is finished, actually it will show us its ID, the video ID that's already uploaded. And see, actually the video is uploaded. We get the video's ID. And actually this video, besides uploading to my account, it already submitted to the playlist that I want to submit for. And here was like the YouTube Direct Lite for iOS. So in this project, we demonstrated the YouTube Data APIs, such as we actually pulled from the user's playlist. We used the iframe embed player so that we would be able to play those users like YouTube videos, as well as we used the Data API uploads, the resumable uploads, so that we were able to upload videos to YouTube. And you can use this project to start your application instead of like starting from scratch, as well as you can go here to find the best examples as well. Thanks for listening to me today, and Ibrahim Muluk from YouTube.